There is something rather peculiar about the crash of Yeti Airlines flight 691. This video is not graphic, but does show in a technical way what happened to the aircraft and so may upset some viewers. You will see the two videos from this crash and will hear from the eyewitness who recorded the video from his balcony. The preliminary crash report reveals a wrong lever caused this accident. I will explain and illustrate this so you can better visualize how this tragedy unfolded and what makes it so puzzling. This was a daily half-hour flight from Kathmandu to Pokhara. It took off from the capital at 10:30 a.m. and the accident happened at 10:57. To the north are the Himalayas. The brand new Pokhara airport had only been open for 2 weeks. The aircraft was an ATR-72. The first video was filmed from a window at the back of the plane. This was a Facebook live stream by a passenger from India. It records two segments of the landing approach. The eyewitness was standing here. He was by chance filming the aircraft. Then, to his horror, it crashed just 60 meters away. He lowers his phone as he stands in disbelief.
I saw the plane in the sky. Then I put on my camera. It was on a low height. At that time, the sound was very low. It feels like this way. Then only I noticed that now the plane is going to crash into our places and there will be a huge blast. At the same time, there was an earthquake. There was a huge flame. I can feel the heat of flame from my place. Plane first hit the other side of the gorge and then came to this side of the river. You know, I was shocked by that. I was not able to run. I can see, I can listen, but you know, I can't move my legs at that time. You know, I was like, you know, I'm lost in somewhere else. I just stood still. And then after a few moments, when I moved from here to another side of my house, then I saw that there were already people gathered over there. There was a rescue team. They had started rescue operation.
Flights to this airport usually come from Kathmandu, following an almost straight line. Earlier in the day, the same pilot crew had landed using this straight approach. On this flight, the pilot requested to land in the other direction. This took it on a circular route over the city. The terrain requires a compact circuit, as well as overflying the other active runway. This increased pilot workload. Airport landing procedures from this direction had not yet been fully finalized. Each leg of the landing circuit has a standardized name. In the first view out the window from the live stream, the hilltop temple is in view. Cross triangulation confirmed a ground speed of 160 knots, which is about typical. The second view out the window is past the stadium. The speed is now just approximately 105 knots, which is too slow. And we can see the flaps are fully down. The aircraft track has been retraced from careful cross triangulation and retiming of the videos. This map shows this recreated flight path. The wide lines are the tracks where there is video evidence. The thin lines are the estimated track in between. The preliminary accident report has been released. There is a link in the video description. The report finds no evidence of mechanical failure. It describes that an incorrect lever movement depowers both propellers in error on downwind leg. 60 seconds later, the aircraft stalls from insufficient flying speed and crashes in the turn onto final approach. So how did it all go so wrong? This is the replay according to the timestamps in the preliminary report. The junior pilot has flown the whole flight. She is being evaluated and after this flight would be authorized to fly as captain on this route in the future. At 60 seconds to go, she calls flaps 30. The senior pilot replies flaps 30 and descending. But instead of moving the flap lever, he depowers the propellers. They are no longer providing thrust. The propeller blade angles can be adjusted for optimum forward thrust and efficiency. They can be reversed for braking on landing. Feathering a prop lines it up to be straight into the airflow. This is done on the ground when the plane should not move. If an engine fails, its prop is feathered to minimize drag. But in normal flight, they are never feathered. The levers are intentionally very different to prevent confusion. The flap lever handle is shaped like a wing, and the levers are unlocked in different ways. The flap handle is lifted up to unlatch before moving. Changing the props from auto pitch to feather would have required squeezing the triggers under the handles to unlatch. It seems unthinkable that any experienced pilot would confuse these and make such a basic mistake, let alone a senior instructor pilot. 56. A master caution chime sounds. The prop torque has dropped to about zero. Engine power raised to 44%. Pilots go through the before landing checklist. Now the flaps are fully lowered. The speed is dropping all the time. Very soon it will be flying too slowly to stay airborne. The control tower gives landing clearance. The turn should be started to final approach, but they keep straight on base leg. Power levers to full power. Junior pilot calls, no power, no power. Control is handed to the senior pilot. The first stall warning. And the second. The aircraft stalls with an abrupt wing drop. You should now have some idea of how busy it can get in the cockpit and how fast things can go wrong. This is why it is so essential that pilots are exposed to all scenarios in a simulator, so training and muscle memory is second nature when facing an emergency. Moving the wrong lever is an inexplicable error and is very puzzling. This investigation is ongoing and will focus on the circumstances inside the cockpit as well as human factors and pilot burden. The final report will shed more light on how this tragic accident could have happened and make appropriate recommendations and changes that are in the interests of safer flying. Let us not forget those who have tragically lost loved ones in this accident. They deserve a full and honest investigation to uncover all there is to know about why this happened. I hope this video was useful. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in my next video.